After a cloudy start, the skies cleared to a warm and mostly sunny day with a sea breeze picking up this afternoon. It reached a top of 28 degrees in Penrith, 27 in Richmond and Campbelltown, 25 in Kellyville and Parramatta, 24 the top in Gosford and 26 in the city. That's a degree warmer than average. Most of New South Wales was fine today. It was a little cooler than average in the east, but 2 to 7 degrees above average in the far west, only reaching 21 in Wollongong, 26 degrees in Coffs Harbour, a warmer 30 in Wagga Wagga. Tomorrow there's an extreme heatwave warning across parts of WA and South Australia lasting until Thursday, while a mild to severe heatwave will spread over Queensland, the Northern Territory and into western New South Wales, while a tropical low is sitting off the Solomon Sea and is expected to develop into a tropical cyclone. There is barely any rain around, staying dry in Brisbane tomorrow, 30 degrees, sunny and 32 in Canberra, with a top of 27 on the way for Melbourne. No rain is expected across New South Wales tomorrow and it will really start to heat up, with inland temperatures reaching the mid to high 30s, even the 40s, while coastal areas will range from 28 in Wollongong, 29 in Newcastle and a warmer 32 in Bega. Sydney will be hot and sunny tomorrow with light to moderate northeasterlies, heading for very warm tops of 35 degrees in Richmond and Penrith, 33 on the way for Blacktown, Liverpool and Campbelltown, 27 for Terre Hills, 28 degrees in the city and 25 in Cronulla. Let's take a look ahead, and the sunny skies will continue on Wednesday with a top of 26, reaching 28 by Thursday, a partly cloudy 30 degrees on Friday, while Saturday is looking hot, 35 degrees before a possible shower or two on Sunday with a top of 25. There is a wide range of overnight lows. Tonight will be the coolest, dipping to 17 degrees, while Saturday night will only drop to a balmy 24. In our west, sunny and 32 on Wednesday, a possible shower on Thursday, 34 degrees, heading for a scorching 38 on Friday. Then take a look at Saturday, a sweltering 42 degrees. We haven't seen a day that hot since February 2020, Georgie.
Hello again. Summer might be unfashionably late, but it felt like the new season was finally with us today. The city warmed up to 32.6, the first time it's hit the 30s in almost a month. Most suburbs joined the city in the 30s. Avalon has been the warmest, 34. Ferny Creek fell a little short with a top of 27, but still a beautiful sunny day. Western and northern parts of the state also warmed up into the 30s. It was 37 at Horsham and Charlton, 38 at Mildura, but it's been a little cooler through East Gippsland, 26 at Orbost, 23 at Mallacoota. There's been very light showers across Gippsland today, so riverine flooding is receding. A few are still under a moderate flood warning. The Snowy River at Orbost. The Mitchell River is easing at Bairnsdale. It's slow going at Sale Wharf, though, with the flooding from the Thompson River easing very gradually. Elsewhere around the country, showers and storms have been clinging to the Queensland coast today. A narrow band has delivered falls of up to 50 millimetres so far. Tasmania has had a very cloudy day. You can barely see it, but most of the mainland has been dry and clear, although very hot through some parts. And a heat wave will affect huge parts of the country this week, with temperatures of more than 44 degrees for these darker areas. Capital cities will escape the worst of the heat. Tomorrow, Canberra is heading for 32 degrees, Brisbane 30, Adelaide and Perth 29, Sydney 28, and Hobart's 24 is 4 degrees warmer than the December average. Back home, it'll be quite a hot night through the far north, with minimums of 17 and 18, up to 20 at Mildura. Then the heat will really ramp up during the day. Mildura is expected to nudge 40 degrees, 38 at Swan Hill, 36 at Echuca and Shepparton. Areas south of the ranges should warm up into the high 20s, but a cool change will arrive in the southwest earlier in the day. So Warrnambool is only expected to reach 22, areas inlet 23. It'll be a mild night across Melbourne with minimums of 14, 15 and 16. And it'll be a very sunny start to the day, so it'll warm up quickly with a top of 31 degrees at Coldstream, 30 at Melton and Epping. A little cooler through eastern Bayside suburbs, 26 at Moorabbin and Frankston, 23 at Rosebud. Then a cool change will arrive in the afternoon, although it won't be dramatic, just dropping temperatures a few degrees. There could be rumbles of thunder in the Dandenong and Yarra ranges, and they could bring a few light showers. After an overnight low of 14, Geelong's expected to reach 27. The city is also heading for 27, but it'll be a warmer night with a low of 16. The southerly change will leave us with a cooler day on Wednesday, 22, but under light winds and partly cloudy skies, it'll be quite pleasant. 24 on Thursday, a top of 29 on Friday, but showers will develop. At this stage, it looks like up to 10 millimetres. Heavier showers on Saturday, up to 20 millimetres, a much cooler 18 degrees. Just a light shower or two on Sunday and Monday, along with maximums of 21 and 22. But a lovely summer's day tomorrow, a low of 16, and a very sunny morning, then a top of 27 before an afternoon cool change arrives. But we'll barely notice it, just a gentle cool change, Alicia.
Oh, Mia, at the moment, there's still a couple of lingering storms in the scenic rim and through the Somerset Dam sort of council area, but it certainly looks that way around the city at the moment. There's some dark clouds, and I'm thinking any time between 8 and midnight, I don't think we'll see any storms, but certainly a bit of a sprinkle, a couple of light showers over the next few hours. There were some violent and severe storms today. Let's have a look at the radar. Firstly, some storms fired up on the Gold Coast between Burleigh and Miami. On the north side, it was Mullaney through to Maroochydore, but it was Gympie that was smashed with those gigantic hailstones today. Thankfully, yeah, we're not likely to see any of that into this evening. Let's have a look at temperatures now over southeast Queensland. A very warm and humid day, but a southeasterly change relaxed temperatures on the coast. High 20s for the coast and bayside suburbs, and it was low 30s for the inner suburbs. Here in Brisbane, 32 degrees today. 33 was the max in Ipswich, Bow Desert and Gatton. Toowoomba hit 30. To the weather map, showers and thunderstorms across Western Australia, the top end, and Queensland's north. Heat building and spreading across Central Australia. A front will cool down Tasmania. We're expecting a tropical cyclone to form in the Coral Sea over the next 24 to 36 hours. For the capitals, sunny and warm in Perth, Melbourne, Canberra and Sydney. Showers and storms in Darwin, a hot one for Alice Springs, 41 degrees. Possible shower in Cairns, and for the rest of Queensland, we're looking at some hot and humid air for Townsville and Mackay with the chance of a shower. Low 30s through the Capricornia with a possibility of a shower tomorrow. Hot and very warm through the Wide Bay and Burnett and the chance of a shower. Hot inland, we're looking at 40 degrees for Mount Isa, 40 in Longreach and 36 for Roma. Here in the southeast for your Tuesday, partly cloudy. The best chance of a shower tomorrow will be up around the Sunshine Coast. We're looking at light to moderate southeasterly winds, a little bit stronger than today. Overnight temperatures 17 to 21 on the coast, while daytime highs, we're looking at high 20s bayside and the coast, once again pushing into the low 30s for the suburbs and inland. Moreton Bay, southeasterly winds 10 to 15 knots, they'll turn easterly later, and the seas below 1 metre. Brisbane, partly cloudy, light to moderate easterlies, a top of 30 degrees. 7 day outlook, sunny with low 30s for Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Early cloud clearing Saturday and 31, Sunday 30 with a possible late shower. Now Ipswich, sunny Wednesday and 34, Thursday, Friday looking at 33, mostly sunny and 33 degrees on Saturday. There is the chance of just a late shower developing on Sunday. For the Goldie, mostly sunny and 29 degrees Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, 30 on Saturday, late showers are possible for your Sunday. Sunshine Coast fine and 29 for Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. A shower or two developing for Sunday afternoon. So the forecast for the rest of the week looking pretty simple. It will be humid. Temperatures warm and above average, but the main focus is keeping an eye on this tropical cyclone that's forming in the Coral Sea. It'll be called Jasper and we'll keep an eye on that each day for you.
Well, Brendan, depends on where you live because it's a bit of a mixed bag really. In Adelaide, we're on the lucky side of the situation, with temperatures dipping off for the next few days, but in the north those temperatures are soaring. So I'll take you through it. Today here in Adelaide, it was a hot one. 36 degrees was our top, but already it has started to cool down. We've got this little shallow change coming in, and at the moment we're sitting at around 31 degrees. Across the suburbs, there was plenty of heat around as well. 37 degrees was the top at Elizabeth and also at Mawson Lakes. But if you did spend the day hanging out by the beach, it was 34 degrees at Glenelg. So already today, the heat is just oppressive in the north. 44 degrees at Port Augusta, 43 at Whyalla, with heatwave warnings in place for increasing zones through the north all week. Renmark copped some heat too with 41, then Kadena, Murray Bridge and Keith all got to a hot 38. There is this shallow change on the charts that's easing off the heat for Adelaide and some coastal areas, but not everywhere is that lucky, with heaps of heat still pumping into our north. And around the country too, it really is all about the heat. Sydney and Perth have just had their hottest springs on record. And this new heat wave will impact a huge chunk of the country from regional WA across to western New South Wales and Queensland. So this forecast is so full on. Oak Valley in our north is forecast for 47 degrees tomorrow and Tarcoola 46 degrees. Roxby Downs is bracing for 45. Moving south, you've got Renmark heading for, it's still pretty hot, 38 degrees, but we do see the benefit of this shallow change along the coast. So look at Kingscote, for example, with a much more inviting 27 degrees in store. I know where I would rather be, that's for sure. On the water, we do need to take care. The other element in the mix is big winds out west. So we have marine wind warnings in place for the western coastline, but on metro waters, it is calmer. South to southwesterlies 10 to 15 knots in the early afternoon and seas around a metre. Adelaide will also benefit from this shallow change. So around our suburbs tomorrow, we're likely to land in the high 20s or low 30s, 31 degrees for Elizabeth. Then we've got a top of 29 degrees on the way in the city with a warm overnight low tonight of around 18 degrees. After that, we're likely to hit the 32 degree mark for Wednesday and Thursday. Friday also looking in the low 30s, but with the chance of a shower creeping onto the forecast. And then on the weekend, we're back down to 21 degrees.